Hi, this is Kurt with Travers Tool Company. Today we're going to talk about drills and drivers. We're going to compare the two and talk about the differences. One of the big differences between the drill and the driver is the fact that the drill, when it's on its hammer function, has a reciprocal hammering function so that when it's drilling, you have it set to be a hammer drill. It actually forces the drill bit into whatever it's drilling. Say if you're drilling concrete or something else that's hard, maybe tile, it'll speed that drill up and make it work better. So it's reciprocal. Compared to the driver, it also has a hammering function in it, but rather than reciprocating, it rotates. So when you're driving that screw that's maybe a big lag bolt that's hard to turn, it'll just force that screw in there because of the way that hammer function rotates. Something else about it, you can see that it's quite a bit smaller than the drill bit. It's a little bit lighter. It's easier to use, so you're gonna last longer. So even if you have an easy task with small screws, you're gonna last a lot longer using a driver than you will with a drill. As you're probably aware, the way you would put a bit into the drill is you just tighten it in the chuck. But when it comes to the driver, just stick it in there and it's done. So let's do a little race here to compare the differences between these two. I have a screw just barely started into the wood, and I'm going to run them both in at exactly the same time, and let's see which one gets there first. The drill, I have set to the drilling mode, not the hammer mode. I don't think I'd need that for a screw that small. So let's get these in here. And ready? One, two, three, go. As you can see, the drill ran that screw into the piece of wood a little bit faster than the driver did. So let's step up the game a little bit and go with a bigger screw and see what happens. So we're going up into a bigger screw, actually a lag bolt, and I have it in hammer mode. So let's see what happens. You'll hear that hammer function kick in too. That's it. That's as far as it would go. All right, so remember that a drill has two speeds. I'm going to put it into the lower speed because it has more torque. Let's see what happens. And it does finish the job. Boy, that was a lot of pressure though. So the lower speed on the drill does drive the screw in a little bit farther than when it's in the higher speed. Now we're going to do the same screw and the same piece of wood with our driver. Let's see what happens. There we go. Wow.
Dang.
Oh boy. Wow, that hurt. So what did we learn here today? First of all, no big surprises when you're drilling the smaller screws. The drill works just fine. It's even a little bit quicker than the driver, but not too much of a difference. When we moved up to the bigger lag bolts, the drill really didn't work so well. If you noticed, I had to shift it into lower gear because at high gear, it didn't even finish putting the screw in down to the end of the threads. Problem with that is that in the lower gear, it has a lot more torque. So that torque was transferred through the drill into my arms. That did not feel good. I was really surprised to feel that much torque and actually pain in my wrist trying to hold on to that thing. And meanwhile, as you probably noticed, when I was holding the driver, even these big screws, I was holding onto it loosely. The torque was not transferred into my wrist. The torque is right in the driver itself with that rotational hammering function. That's what was creating the torque, not me trying to hang on for dear life. So if you're doing a lot of these things, if you're driving in a lot of screws, whether it's the big ones or the small ones even, I would recommend using the driver, not the drill. For just household stuff, you're doing a few of them, the drill works just fine for the smaller stuff. Thank you for watching. I hope that we could shed some insight on which one of these is the best tool for you. Harder than the skid.